Hi guys, I'm Greg Alba. Welcome to the Real Rejects YouTube channel. We have a YouTube. Last night I was spending like an hour trying to figure out how the hell to do a live stream on Twitch because it's not as simple as hitting a button apparently. Working on a Twitch, we got a Patreon. Oh my gosh, the Real Rejects are expanding. Danny Unchained from the Danny Unchained channel. He does reactions. He's visiting from New York. He hit me up. He said, Greg, I want to see you naked. And I said, better yet, why don't you just come on the channel? We could collab together.
Now I'm here.
Today. Now he's here.
Waiting on the steps. I was about to throw a rock on his window.
You should have, man. Hey, I said I'd be back at 1:30. You should have at like 1:22, okay? It's your fault. I blame you. This is war right now. War for the Planet of the Apes trailer number three. Are you ready, Danny Unchained?
Yep.
I wonder who's going to win.
In the staring contest?
Yeah. You'll win.
Sexy man.
20th Century Fox. This video is monetized for sure. I know that now. It's Fox always. Let's see.
You don't see that every day.
No. No, you don't, Danny.
Who is child?
Jack Reacher's daughter, too.
She was you.
She has no one else.
Wow, look at them.
We are not savages. Apes fight only to survive.
Bad human kill apes. All dead now, a long time.
Bad humans.
Soldier.
Years from now, your children will ask you, what did you do in the greatest war? And you can tell them, I fought to protect this world.
Monkey created this.
But now, we will bring an end to their kind.
Smart as hell. You're stronger than we are. But you're taking this all much too personally.
So emotional!
What?
I did not start this war.
Who is that ape? That's gonna be one suspenseful ass mother effing movie right there.
Another masterpiece in the works.
I hope so. I hope so. That's my hope there, Danny Unchained.
Remember when Woody said it's emotional? Yeah, he doesn't need to make it obvious, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Who's that one ape at the beginning?
No time.
So cute. He's the most adorable one of them all.
Kind of reminds me of the gingerbread man from Shrek.
A little bit. He was so adorable. I really hope he doesn't die. I hope they're not setting up that ape to get killed. I haven't seen the other Planet of the Apes, like the OG ones, in a long time. I don't know if that's like, oh, that's the ape who's in the actual Planet of the Apes. You know, he's going to stick around. But I don't know. I was most drawn to that character.
When you watch the movie, I bet you'd be crying in your seat. But right now in the trailer, it kind of seems funny.
It kind of seems funny. I don't know. It was adorable. It was like touching my heart. It's like, you're so cute. This film looks pretty epic. I mean, I find it really fascinating how I'm so rooting for the apes to win.
I know.
Isn't that weird?
It's like how in Aliens, you're going to want aliens to win.
Kind of. I don't know. I feel like in Aliens, the aliens are scary. I mean, it's as if you don't like, that's a different thing. If it's like one of those movies where the monsters are more interesting than the humans, so we want the monsters to win. Here, you know, like the way the franchise has been going, I thought it's been setting up like how Caesar, where he's going to become the ultimate.
Yeah, I really love his character. You know?
Yeah.
He's not just a human being. He's not a human being. He has a character.
He's more than just this. He's a soul. He has a soul. I thought when this franchise got rebooted with Rise of the Planet of the Apes that they were setting him up. Mm. You remember those trailers? Rise of the Planet of the Apes. Right. Apes are bad. And then when that movie came out, people loved Caesar. Then Dawn comes around and he's a great character.
Yeah,
and
you, thanks to Matt Reeves.
And you don't want the humans and the apes to fight. Like, even though you know it's coming, you're like, I don't want this to happen. And then now that we're at the war point, it's the Caesar's the last thing from an antagonist to me. He's the protagonist. He's the hero. He's the one I want to win. I'm like, I'm hoping all the humans die and the apes actually conquer.
Right.
And they are going to. We know how it turns out.
Kind of seems like in this the humans are the villains.
Yeah, yeah. They've really taken a side here. That's what I liked about Dawn, because the humans and the apes are like, they're just too conflicting.
They're trying to get along.
Yeah, right? It's just a clash. Work. There's like a fear and philosophy battle going on, and then they break out into a fight. It's like you don't want them to fight. Here, it seems like, oh, Woody Harrelson's just a bad guy.
Yeah.
Every trailer we see, Woody Harrelson, he's just a bad guy. Like, there's nothing here that gives me a hint that he's like, oh, he's a full-rounded human being, and I get where he's coming from. And so I find that interesting that for this one, they're giving us a direct villain.
Right.
As opposed to the Rise and Dawn and didn't have that. Mm-hmm. And here we have a direct villain in the form of Woody Harrelson, star of Now You See Me 2.
Mm-hmm. And Hunger Games.
And Hunger Games, yeah. He played PETA, right?
Yeah. PETA, no.
Yeah, he played PETA. Someone in the comedy would be like, no, he didn't, no. Dumbass.
According to the trailer, it's like a masterpiece. They did the same thing with Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. They set up the same way, and it kind of seems like it's doing it over again.
A little bit. I feel like it's going to be a lot more action. Because Dawn of the Planet of the Apes isn't like action packed, like the crazy action scenes you see in the trailers didn't come into like the finale. Here it's like it seems like there's gonna be battles throughout. I'm interested what they're gonna do with the little human girl. Yeah. That came weird.
Kind of seems like she's gonna be another X-23.
Yeah, she's gonna be X-23.
Father daughter, but it's gonna be ape and daughter.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. I mean, it looks like there's gonna be a lot of death on both sides of the spectrum. Like from looking at the trailer, like they were showing like apes and you're getting shot, and then like characters having emotional death moments. I mean, obviously we're gonna get that. I'm just saying that it's crazy how like the trailers, not exactly because I don't remember like all the ape personalities too well, but it seems like there's gonna be a lot of characters that you grow to care about that will actually get killed off, which is not common in movies to have like several characters.
I think that's gonna happen in this one. I think she's gonna die.
The little girl?
I think Caesar's gonna die.
Caesar? Why would Caesar? Caesar's around for the... Isn't he in like...
I think he will die at the end of the movie.
Really?
Just because of the way it's playing out.
Wait.
We see apes on the human side. You know, you saw reloading the gun and everything. So we see him on both sides. So not all apes are with Caesar.
Yeah.
Even though he's like the president of them, you know, the king.
Yeah. I feel like this movie's gonna have a lot more debate about, like, in terms of, like, the, you know, point of views. Because you're right, there's
Batman
apes.
Superman versus humans.
Yeah. BVS was loaded with that.
Yeah.
Because, you know, those apes were... The apes that are working with the humans, I can't tell if they're just prisoners or if some of them are thinking, no, we're on your side,
right?
You know, I think it'd be a lot more interesting if they were more than just prisoners. True. And there were a few apes that were intentionally fighting alongside the human beings, you know. I think that would just make for a much more interesting conflict. And man, last thing I really like emphasize in trailers for blockbusters is like good effects, because you kind of just expect.
Oh, you already know Matt Reeves.
Signed
on to do Batman. Come on.
Yeah, exactly. You know, CGI Batman's gonna look great.
Oh, yeah. You see a lot of that.
But when the apes are talking and stuff, it's like, wow, it looks like real apes are talking.
Yeah,
you know, it looks incredible.
They use the same technology that they use in Avatar.
I think one of the best things that with visual effects that's so key and vital to making effects.
Cinematography.
Like exactly. Thank you for pointing that out. It's like the right lighting. I mean, if you watch Spider-Man 1 and Spider-Man 2, the Tobey Maguire ones, the biggest difference with the visual effects is how they did the cinematography when Spider-Man's web-slinging. And that's that plays a factor here. Same thing with the Hulk and the Incredible Hulk.
Yeah.
The biggest difference that makes it look so much better is beyond the effects getting better is the cinematography that blends with it here. And I think that's what that works so well here in the shots that we get. Because I last saw Dawn of the Planet of the Apes on Blu-ray, I thought that was a bad idea.
It was a bad idea. I saw it in theaters, so...
I saw it in theaters, and it looked amazing. Then I saw it on Blu-ray, and the crystal clearness of everything made it look more fake. the apes and stuff. I can't wait to watch this. This looks like a great
looks amazing.
Film. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes was absolutely one of my favorite films of
mine too.
What that year that came out. Anyway, guys, hey, subscribe to The Real Rejects. Click that notification bell. Please go help support the channel by joining our Patreon. You get a lot of exclusive perks there too if you help out with us. You help me, I help you, or whatever the line is from Jerry Maguire. Danny Unchained from the Danny Unchained channel. Go check out his videos over there. He's a handsome fella with a handsome body and handsome buttocks. I'm telling you, I've seen it. It's the first thing he showed me when he flew in from New York. Here's a picture of my ass. And I said, man, you are unchained. Cutting!